These are my two boats. On the left, a Pearson Triton 28 monohull, and this is my F24 Mark I Corsair Trimaran, 1992. I've done a lot of upgrades to make it more safe for cruising offshore and living aboard comfort. Replaced the hatches and deck plates. All of those are new. New 3/8 thick acrylic windows, Dyneema lashings for the nets. There's a Dodger with a stainless steel frame. Currently it has a Yamaha 6-horse motor. It does have a few gel coat cracks and blemishes here and there from being used. See the discoloration of the gel coat here where previous owners had patched it. And this is the solar tracker mount, 50 watt solar panel, which you can turn and angle towards the sun, or remove it, take it off for storage. The second solar panel is up here on deck. It's a flat, semi-flexible 50 watt panel. And there's the vent fitting for the composting toilet bucket. There's a compass, can be read from inside or outside. I noticed when sailing that the boat is so low to the water that if you were in big following seas, it's possible that waves could come in and roll right up and threaten to flood the boat. So I made this removable hinged plexiglass panel here that will resist waves coming in but still have drainage when needed, or if heavy water landed inside the cockpit, it would just open and flush right out. We've got one very deep cockpit locker here, and it's got this mesh bag to keep things from falling down into the bilge. And on the other side is the gas tank locker. And presently I'm not using it because the outboard motor I have has a integral tank, but it also has the option of using the remote tank. Now this is a 1992 Mark I F24, and what I like over the Mark II is that this boat has a standard sliding hatch for the companionway, and you can then fit a standard Dodger. So it's with a stainless steel frame. And the Mark II had a pop top, which gives you a little more headroom when it's up, but it's kind of awkward, and I used to have one, a F27, and I prefer not having it. And the Mark II has a dagger board inside that lifts and drops vertically, so if you hit the bottom with the dagger board down, it's going to break off or damage the boat and possibly flood it. But the Mark I here has a center board under the cushion here, which is offset off the center line of the hull, and that's controlled with these two lines here to raise and lower the center board. And if you strike something, then the line can give in the clutch and the board can tilt back. Up here on the bow is a recessed anchor locker that drains overboard directly. Inside, these boats originally came with what they call derisively mouse fur, which was a hull fabric liner that was glued on with contact cement onto all the surfaces of the boat inside. And that's hard to clean, and I didn't like it at all. It traps mold and dirt, and hard to wash, and if you do wash it, it's even harder to dry it. So I've stripped 100% of it out and fared the hull inside and painted it. It's a single part latex marine paint on the off-white areas, and the countertops and the sole is a two-part paint, and there's some non-skid in the sole. Looking aft here, we've got a hold-down strap for the table. Otherwise, it folds up. It's a single burner Orico alcohol stove. And the galley sink has a foot pump, which is connected to these water jugs that can be pulled out for filling. And that brings water to the sink. Very convenient to have it on a foot pump. And there's the Raymarine depth sounder on this side. Over here is a Garmin 5-inch chart plotter with a swing-out bracket so you can view it outside or inside. I've replaced all the electrics, and so got all LED lights. And this is the switch panel. And the new wiring in the locker. And this is a VHF AIS. Everything is a tight fit in this F24. Down here I've got the battery strapped in and secured. And I've got a fuse on the positive battery post. And the negative from the battery goes to the shunt to this monitor. And for charging, I only have a solar panel, two of them. I have the EP Ever 20 amp MPPT charger back there. It's kind of hidden. And then the control panel is an optional MT50. That I installed here. Now originally it had a small switch panel right here, and I moved it and I made this locker access door, so there's more storage there. And then this settee doubles as a bunk when you fold up this extension and put one of the backrest cushions down there. So there's the bunk with the cushion insert. And there's still space to walk through, so you won't disturb somebody if you have the bunk open. Up forward, there's one long bunk. I think it's about 6.5 feet long. And this cushion is held down with Velcro. And under here is a composting toilet bucket. And it has a vent hose that comes up here. And that's how you turn on the vent. And for added ventilation and visibility in the V-berth, we have these two opening port lights. Thank you.
into the unknown void that has no end. Swept along the open road that don't seem to begin. Come with me and love me, babe. I may be back again. Meantime, I'll keep sailing down my highway in the wind. Evenings just begin the days and follows with the night. Love you and to be with you and say that it's alright. Love me while you have me, babe. I may be back again. Meantime, I'll keep sailing down this highway in the wind. There's times I feel like going, and there's times I want to stay. Times that I ain't feeling well, and times I feel okay. Now you have time to love me, babe, I may have time again. Meantime, I'll keep sailing down this highway in the wind. The fortune teller tells me that I have somewhere to go. Look and try and understand and wonder how she knows. So I must be going now. I'm losing time, my friend, looking for